We welcome everybody to the Garden State. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Here's the former Sooner, Austin Seibert, to get this one started. And we are underway from MetLife Stadium. Amir Smith-Marset now from his end zone. And able to get this out to the 25. And New York set to take the field. Jones looking to throw it on the first play. And his first pass is incomplete.
We have to see what kind of looks this defense is going to throw at him as this game moves along, but they're in a zone to start. I do think we'll see plenty of man coverage as we move along, but the first throw of this one, incomplete.
So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25. Now Jones. He'll get this into the hands of the wideout from LSU. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A gain there of 21 yards.
And everyone wants a dynamic receiver on the outside, and he may take it to a new level. Slot fade, one of his favorite routes when he played at LSU. And head coach Brian Daboll, he loves the competitiveness that Neighbors brings to the table.
Throwing Jones. There's a short one to the tight end Johnson. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. Ball on the 47-yard line. Here's second down and 3. Now the first carry for Devin Singletary. And he'll only get a yard to bring up 3rd and 1. Here now, 3rd and 1 yard. They'll try and run for this with Singletary. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. 3rd and 2 is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. But they went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
On 1st and 10, Jones. There's a short one to the tight end, Johnson. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
Such a tough position to defend near the line, even when you add a second defender, but the big man shrugged off the extra body and made the play call a success.
Here's a 2nd and 5. They'll give this to Singletary running right, and he gets it down to the 32. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a 1st down.
Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. On 1st down, they stick with Singletary. And he struggles to get a yard here, maybe a yard, down to the 31.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Jones' throw taken in by Slayton. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. That'll go for a gain of 7. And that'll leave him with a 3rd and 2.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Giants 1st down as they get 5 there on 3rd and 2.
Solid opening drive so far, Charles. They've moved this football into field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with six and not three.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want to throw body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping one uppercut will take care of the end of this drive.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Ball at the 14 for second and five. Right there. Singletary again. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a third and three.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. The 13th play now coming on this opening drive. Here's third down. Back to throw. Jones. That is caught. And the Giants are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Well, no question, this is exactly how they wanted to start this football game. And nice pass there. Now they're set up beautifully, Charles, to finish this off with a touchdown.
Yeah, but they've still got to finish it off, partner, and that means they've got to execute at this stage of the field. So we've seen many teams march it right to the goal line and not cash in. They've got something dialed up.
And he's going to bowl his way into the end zone for a Giants touchdown. Devin Singletary. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Giants will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon.
It's not often you talk about statement drives coming right at the start of a game, but that was some statement there. That drive took them the length of the field, and as I look at the clock, ate up nearly the entire first quarter as well. Great work up front, clearing space, and an ideal finish on the touchdown run.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. It didn't take long to see our first penalty of the game, did it?
We always talk about everyone wanting to get into the game in a hurry. The officials did as well.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Daniels now on first and 10. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. And Washington with the football here to begin quarter number two. Here's second and 10. As they've got it as we resume action. Now Daniels. Complete to Zacchaeus. And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Here's Daniels. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's going to have a Commanders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
Let's go now. 60 bison. 60 bison.
A first down throw for Daniels. Open man is Noah Brown. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Up
And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive.
From the 35, here's second and a couple. They'll run for the first time here with Brian Robinson.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well.
He's got his target. That's complete. And he's going to have a Commanders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
As you know, so many things in the passing game are based on yardage. Sometimes it's just based on timing. And that's what we saw right there on that play. Third and three, just get the ball right to the receiver.
It's the hitch route. And tell us, what is the hitch route?
Yeah, just take really one step, like you're driving off the line of scrimmage, get the defensive back on his heels, get the ball out to the receiver, and he does the rest.
And he gets this to the other side of midfield, across the 45 before going out. 11 yards there, just like last play. Interior of that line blocked really well on that run, but also the two tight ends, they blocked well too.
Not only have they scouted the line of scrimmage, with their agility, they can get upfield and hit moving targets like linebackers, defensive backs. They do a really good job helping out the running game.
Back to Robinson now on first down.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last two snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field when his number is called. The way he's running it, I'd keep going back to him.
Ball on the 39. Here's the second and five. Robinson with another carry.
And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line.
That one, a first down pickup of 8.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Daniels looking to throw.
Ertz over the middle. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it'll be second down.
And there wasn't much room for the big tight end to do much after the catch. But at least he was able to pick up a solid gain to help his offense continue to move in the right direction.
Here's second and 3.
Second down and a run by Robinson. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Well, you know they had a third down play on standby just in case, but he says no need with that carry. Runs like that will continually earn him more work in this and future contests.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. To the air goes Daniels.
Forced out to his left, and he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
To throw is Daniels.
This is caught. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up first and goal. Now a timeout called for by the offense, as he'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal.
Robinson is not going to get in. In fact, he'll lose a couple of yards back to the 3. The Commanders going to use the second of their timeouts
as he'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. Throwing now is Daniels. Dancing to his left. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
The plan was clearly to challenge them by sending a blitz on second down, but even the extra guys couldn't catch him in the backfield, though. He doesn't scramble for a first, but he does get the last laugh by evading the blitz and getting beyond the line of scrimmage.
Eckler. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about.
Well, you hate that defensively. They had him pretty well corralled, but the face mask, that obviously changes things.
Yeah, it's a bit frustrating because you feel like you did everything right. You had him stop, but the hand gets up just a little too high, and the natural inclination is to hold on, and that's going to get called every time.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. And the Giants with one final possession here in this first half. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And just 25 seconds to go in the half now as they've got it first and 10. That's complete. It's Neighbors. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half.
And the Giants with one final possession here in this first half. And with decent starting field position, they're maybe only a couple completions away from field goal range.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Looking to throw, Jones. And now the ball's out, fumble near midfield.
And it's Washington that scoops it up.
Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think you should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty good at finding ways to knock it out.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. This will be spotted just shy of midfield. A 59-yard attempt. And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice, an ambitious effort, but it's well short. And this game will remain tied here in quarter number two.
And this is a commentary on today's kickers and just how good they are that a coach would think about running his guy out there to try a 59-yarder. Here it backfires on them, but as a kicker, you have to appreciate the confidence that they showed in you.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. 1 second, all that remains. He's going to float this one deep right side. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback.
60 Bison, 60 Bison.
On first down, here's Daniels to throw. Buying time to his left. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
As we both know, there was a lot that went into why they made him their first-round pick this year, and part of it was what they saw in college, his playmaking ability when things break down. As soon as he saw he wasn't getting a lane to throw, he pivoted and found an alternate way to the marker.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. It's a first down for Washington on a pickup of 11.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. And it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
I really like the vision he displayed on that play because he saw there wasn't a lane to completely break off a huge gain. So he found where there was the most space and got what he could. A nice, dirty run that's a positive play for the offense.
From the 42-yard line, here's a second and four. Back to throw. Daniels. Caught by the tight end, Ertz. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 31-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. Well, there wasn't much of a window there, Charles. Had to deal with a couple of defenders, but able to find his big tight end.
And, Bartner, we know double coverage is a challenge for any player to try to defeat. But maybe it's a little easier if you're one of those big tight ends because you have a size advantage on just about anyone trying to cover you, and you can use your body to create some space. Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops, and escape this drive.
Second and 10. Straight ahead, it's Robinson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
They have three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
On third down, Daniels. And that will be incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield of man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
Austin Seibert sets up for the field goal try. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. Seibert's kick is good, and they take the lead here now at 10-7. So the defense able to force the interception and the offense working their way into field goal range and able to get three out of it.
Yeah, and give them credit for that. They took the ball, maneuvered it downfield, and while they couldn't get exactly what they wanted, which was a touchdown, they did get 3 points out of it. So they paid off what the defense gave them. Both sides would be thrilled with that.
After the made field goal, Seibert back out there to kick it away. That's going to be taken at the goal line, and he'll return it. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense.
I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers.
What a quick start to the drive, but not for the team that really needed it. In only a few seconds, the opposing QB found himself on the turf, and the defense is celebrating second and long.
To try again after the sack. Jones going right side. He finds Slayton. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A gain there of 21 yards.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
I did like his decision-making there to make sure they picked up something instead of forcing a throw. Now they've got more manageable play coming up to try and pick up the first down, and don't rule out the possibility that he just keeps it and runs again.
Meanwhile, Jones' throw complete there to Johnson. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
From Commanders territory now, it's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Operating from the gun, Jones. And now the ball's out, fumble near midfield. And the defense says they have it. They do. One play into the ball game, an early turnover. Following the fumble recovery, Daniels. And the giant rush gets home as down he goes. The sack recorded. It's a loss of five, and now it's second down.
Boy, every time I see speed like that off the edge, Charles, I just don't know how these offensive linemen do it. I would think that they would get called for holding every play, and maybe they should have been called for holding on that one.
Yeah, maybe not just holding, but sometimes you end up setting back in the offensive backfield a little bit farther to try and help you with the edge. That's a penalty as well. Sometimes you overset, they'll come inside of you. That's what speed does. It disrupts an offense, and right now you've got to pay attention to this edge rusher on every single down.
In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Zacchaeus here hauling it in. And they do get this across midfield to the 49, but a small consolation prize as he's well short of the first. Before they can get the punt away, whistles as we've come to the end of the third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here at MetLife Stadium. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And it's second down.
I got the sense that the defense created a little momentum for them there, didn't they?
Did their job, forced the punt. Now, nice start to the drive. Offense has to do their part.
Yeah, they certainly do, but what a great start for them. And they've got to go thank the guys on D.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he's going to be stopped well behind the line of scrimmage, and that's pretty much going to wipe out their gain from first down. That's going to go down as a loss of five, and it brings up third down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
And he'll be out right at the 35. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. A give up the middle to Singletary. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
2nd down and 3. Looking to throw. Jones. That caught by Manhurts. It'll be a pickup of 4. Good enough to earn him yet another first down. Off play action. Jones. Oh, the Commanders are going to get there as he's taken down. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack.
Well, partner, I would say just avoid play action, but that's not just been the problem. This defense, they've been getting pressure on all types of pass plays and really piling up the sacks in this contest.
A give, Singletary right side, and he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But bottom line is, he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
That one taken in by Neighbors. And they'll get this across the midfield stripe, but still winding up short of the first down. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Even against double coverage, he found enough of an opening for a noticeable gain. Two guys on him, yet he finds a way to uncover downfield for the completion.
Here's Jamie Gillen now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is, at the 6-yard line. The Commanders' offense returning to the field. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. Evades him at the 10. And they'll get him down up past the 15-yard line.
Let's go! Let's stop him here! Come on, baby! Let's go!
Points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down and mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. And quickly we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Again, it's Robinson. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. All right, so they got that one, Charles, against the center.
And let's remember how difficult it is for the center, because remember, he's got to snap the ball to put the play in motion, and sometimes you got that big guy on your nose, you got sometimes where he's coming at you at an angle. It's a difficult job for him to snap the ball and then execute his block.
Robinson up the middle, and not much of an opening there as he's only going to get this to about the 32. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Second and long, but you got to figure this almost certainly another run. A give left side to Robinson. The Giants going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. They need 12 here. It's third down. On the give, here's Robinson. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35.
Well, they certainly didn't appear to be fired up about their options throwing the football. So, to me, this seems like a case of just kind of taking their medicine there, run the ball, see if they could pick up something. Instead, they were thrown for a loss.
Here's Tressway now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. So now Jones and the Giants down 10-7, a little under a minute to go. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. Jones. That's complete to Smith Marset. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
No timeout. You got to go quick here.
They'll come up now on second down. Jones connects with Slayton. And he'll get this up past the 45. It's a first down, but the tackle comes in bounds. Okay, here we go, boy. 10 seconds to go. 1 final shot. They'll look to throw. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. A fun, close ball game comes to an end. On that last play, Charles, they were on the wrong side of midfield. They needed something near a miracle, and they couldn't get it done.
Yeah, the effort, that was good. Very good, in fact. They were just a little too far out to get a decent look at the end zone for that last opportunity. Couldn't get it done, but a nice game overall.
So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we sign off from MetLife Stadium.